Though public speaking may seem terrifying, it is a skill that can be refined through time. There are three stages in making an effective presentation. They focus on the process of creating, preparing, and delivering. In this module, I will be explaining on the process of creating a presentation. The steps involved in this process tend to be overlooked by many people. However, these steps are considered crucial for a successful presentation. It is very important that the objectives be clearly defined because they determine the structure and the flow of a presentation. One should define the objectives of a presentation by asking, what is the main message of this presentation? What must be achieved and what do I want the audience to walk away with? One must also conduct thorough and up-to-date research of a topic, either through journals, articles, internet, or other means. Since information is often updated in all topic areas, the risk of having outdated, misleading, and flawed presentations is always present. So, when the more research is done, the more knowledgeable and confident a speaker will become. As for knowing the audience, audience analysis allows the presenter to know the needs and experience level of the audience, so that a presentation can be made relevant to them. Find out who the audience members are, what they want to know, along with how and why the presentation will be useful to them. Not only that, build the presentation based on information that will appeal to the audience. If an audience analysis cannot be done in advance, find out what the group knows by asking questions or asking for a show of hands during the presentation. After the objectives have been defined and research has been conducted, organize the information by creating an outline. Make sure to include the introduction, body, and conclusion. Also, prepare graphs, charts, and tables if necessary. Don't forget to give credits to all the sources used. In the introduction, you tell the audience what you are going to tell them. List the agenda, purpose, and goals of the presentation. Use this time to grab the attention of the audience by telling them some significant facts to reinforce the topic. In the body, you tell the audience. Pick important points of discussion and stick to those major points. Audience retention level varies. Therefore, use explicit transitions and make intermediate summaries. Provide examples, comparisons, rhetorical questions, and humor if necessary. In the conclusion, you tell them what you have told them. In this phase, wrap up the presentation by reviewing important points. Give the audience a repetition of the introduction with a sense of closure as well as thank the audience for their time. Also, ask for any questions and possible follow-up. Depending on the presenter's PowerPoint skills, a blank presentation, templates, or themes can be used to get started. A blank presentation gives total control over the content and formatting for each slide. Templates give you a starting point and make it easier to complete your presentation quickly, whereas the themes consist of predefined presentation templates upon which presentations can be built. Whichever options is used, make sure to utilize the appropriate formatting to reinforce the message. Font style, font size, slide background, color scheme, and other major elements need to be consistent throughout the presentation. After choosing the appropriate template and formatting for the presentation, the content, which includes text, graphics, charts, tables, animation, or appendix, should be inserted. Make the content short and precise. Using bullets or a numbered list help keep the slide from being overcrowded. Graphics and charts should only be used when appropriate. Besides the PowerPoint presentation, other multimedias such as videos and demonstrations can make a presentation lively. For future reference, provide the audience with additional materials such as handouts, supporting documents, or product samples. As Murphy's Law states, anything that can go wrong will go wrong. Therefore, the confirmation process will ensure that the presentation is complete and accurate. In checking the content and formatting of the presentation, first, make sure the purpose and goal of the presentation are clearly stated. Second, ensure all the necessary content is covered in the presentation. Third, make sure the formatting is consistent and correct. Fourth, make sure the animations and other special effects are not excessively applied. Fifth, use spelling and grammar check to ensure the presentation is free of errors. PowerPoint provides a style checker which scans a presentation and corrects errors in punctuation, capitalization, and spelling. In checking the computer to be used, make sure the computer that will be used on the day of the presentation has the same features or capabilities as the computer you use to create the PowerPoint presentation. Some computers may not display certain types of fonts, graphics, or animation effects. Lastly, in backing up data, you can either back up data on a flash drive, CD, or preferably by email. It is always wise to have a backup in case something unexpected happens to the original data. Remember to take the backup device to your presentation.